Welcome to the last topic in Philippine Politics and Governance. And welcome back to our YouTube channel. I'm Educado by Sir Arnold Lareño Mercado. This time, let's talk about civil society and social movements. Let's start with simple quotes again. According to Margaret Mead, never depend upon institutions or government to solve any problem. All social movements are founded by, guided by, motivated and seen through by the passion of individuals. According to Joe Biden, no fundamental social change occurs merely because government acts. It's because civil society, the conscience of country, begin to rise up and demand change. Now, this civil society and social movement focuses with social movements and understanding of current theories of both civil society and social movements. So, what is civil society first? According to UN, civil society as the third sector of society, along with the government and businesses. It comprises civil society organizations and NGO or non-governmental organization. Example po ng picture ng civil society. Again, third sector ang tawag sa kanya. Kasama siya ng government and business. Function ng civil organization. According to Puppenhaus and Spark in 2002, ito po yun. Malaki ang kanyang gampanin sa peace building. Functions are protection, monitoring, advocacy and public communication, social cohesion, intermediation and facilitation, and last one is service delivery. According to the Third World Studies Center, the civil society has demonstrated their potential as independent power centers and agents of change. So, ang talagang way talaga sa third world sa third sector is or civil society ay maging agents of change sila or bosses ng karamihan. Civil society, according to Crute 1997, crucial to democratization because it enables and widens participation. So, pinapalawak niya ang participasyon ng mga tao, especially sa Pilipinas, protects citizen from the abuse of state power, and guarantees the political accountability of the state. So, malaking tulong daw talaga ang civil society. Society prevents the state from abusing its power and at the same time, produces to better by being accountable and transparent naman, according to Putnam. Concept of social movement naman. So, kung ang civil society ang third sector, ang social movement naman can be thought of as an organized yet informal social entities that are engaged in extra-institutional conflict that is oriented towards a goal which can be concrete and narrow policy or aim at cultural change. Sila naman yung nasa loob ng civil society. Ito yung mga grupo na kung saan medyo hindi pa formal, kusa na buo, para mapakinggan din ang kanilang mga hinahing batay sa kanilang mga conflicts, etc. Now, we have the different stages of social movements. First is yung emergence, o yung pag-usbong. Then another is coalescence, at yung pagsasama-sama. At ang uli, bureaucratization, which is being strong na ng grupo. Ano ba ang function and contribution ng social movements? According to Gornier and Torres in 2014, in an article entitled Changing the Wind, Notes Towards a Demos Prudence of Law and Social Movements, published in Yale Law Journal, claimed that social movements have played key roles in redefining the meaning of our democracy by creating necessary conditions for a genuine community of consent. According to them, social movements build solidarity through a continuous series of interaction between power holder and person successfully claiming to speak on behalf of constituency lacking formal representation, as well as through connective structure and shared identities that sustain collective action. Kaya nga sila grupo, mapinagsama-samang ideya, adhikain, misyon, at sa pamamagitan nila nare-redefine ang democracy at namibigyan ulit ng atensyon yung mga pangangailangan ng mga tao sa kanilang mga lugar. Social movements tends to emerge initially as a local source of power and moral authority. Actually kasi, ang social movement nagiging source na rin sila ng power kasi pinapakinggan na rin sila ng government, lalo na sa mga moral authority. Social movements create constituents of accountability and alternative authoritative interpretive communities that draw on local resources, can be networks, information, relationships, and cultural symbols to ground the lawmaking process in a moral vision that forces both their legal advocates and the larger society to begin to contend with issues of substantive justice. Another, social movements influence lawmaking. Ayan. So, malaki rin ang kanyang gampanin sa paggawa ng batas, which is the shape of the agenda of the social movement. Social movement may ultimately succeed in changing public opinion. So, siya yung boses, mata ng mga tao sa nangyayaring iba't ibang sitwasyon sa bawat lugar sa bansa. If you have any questions, again, email me at arnraymercado@gmail.com or like my Facebook page for some videos. So don't forget to subscribe in our YouTube channel. I am Edocado. Goodbye, everyone.